know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.
We need your input here. Not an easy choice, I know.
Thanks for handling that.
Welcome along then to what promises to be another fascinating Spanish Grand Prix. It's a race which saw Max Verstappen take victory on his first ever appearance with the Red Bull team in 2016, after that dramatic coming together of Lewis Hamilton and Nico Rosberg. Will we see more moments for the scrapbook here today? The Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya then, a high-speed 2.89 mile circuit which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of turn 9, which we might just see taken flat out this weekend. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Russell, Sainz, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Norris, Magnussen, and Esteban Ocon, Mick Schumacher, Joe, Yuki Tsunoda, and Albon, Vettel, Gasly, Oscar Piastri, and Lance Stroll, Perez, Latifi, Sunshine, and Daniel Ricciardo fills the last spot on the grid. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. And joining me again for the race today, Natalie Pinkham. Why don't we discuss Red Bull? What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within the team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that has definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Issues coming off the practice starts. Watch the RPM on the full start. We don't want you to bog down. Decent parking. Let's try and get a good launch as the lights go out. Somewhere on the MGUK. To manage this, we're going to need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now, just be careful. underbody's taken some damage. You might start to notice it soon. Front is 2.0 seconds. The underbody's taken a little damage, just watch out for it. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Behind is 8.7 seconds. Now. Okay, Schumacher's in the pit. Stay clear of the white line on the exit, or receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Effect should be minimal for now. Okay, there's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time, and there are so far no plans for a safety car. Oscar is into the pit lane. Oscar in the pits. Gap ahead is 9.4 seconds.
cars just ahead of you now. Our gap to the car in front is 11.4 seconds. That's us down a place. Thank you.
is 5.4 seconds.
See how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Charles Leclerc, currently leading the championship standings, extends his lead even further with this result. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, that was certainly an exciting weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for more exciting Formula One action very soon.